Hello, my name is Dan Gelardi, and I'm a BCBA with Brett DiNovi and Associates. Today we'll be discussing discrete trial training for individuals with autism. Discrete trial training, also known as DTT, is a method for individualizing and simplifying instruction to enhance the learning of all individuals. It is a widely used procedure in applied behavior analysis. DTC is shown in research to increase learning opportunities for people of all ages and abilities, yet the information contained here will focus on the utility and research of DTT towards individuals with autism and how it enhances their motivation to learn. Discrete trial consists of five components, which include cue, which known as the discriminative stimulus, or SD. Then we have prompt, response, consequence, and intertrial interview. Research shows DTT is especially useful for teaching children with autism and to add forms of behavior, basically actions previously not performed, to their repertoires and how to make new discriminations, which is making accurate responses to different cues between events. DTT may also be effective for a learner's management of disruptive behavior by teaching replacement of such behaviors with more adaptive ones. DTT format relies on discrete behaviors which have a clear beginning, middle, and end. The learning objective needs to clearly state to the desired antecedent behavior criterion for mastery. Discrete trial is used often in the treatment of people with autism since they tend to have difficulties when it comes to gaining and maintaining attention to stimuli in their environment. Because each discrete trial is short, there are more learning opportunities in a particular period of time than that of standard instruction, and these particular periods maintain shorter periods to be attended to by each individual person. Other benefits include that DTT teaches important skills and discriminations in the areas of imitation, receptive language, expressive language, conversation, sentence, grammar, and syntax. These skill areas in DTT can include expansion of skills through collaboration of other instructional methods. For example, incidental teaching. They use this to increase vocabulary expansion, play skills, amount of responses in conversations, manding, and teaching complex daily living skills. For example, setting the table, going to the bathroom. It can also be utilized when a child with autism maintains difficulties acquiring spoken language, and DTT proves beneficial in successfully teaching children their first words and phrases in sign language. DTT is also effective in teaching picture communication. Next, I will discuss how much and when DTT can be utilized in a treatment program. The schedule of DTT within a treatment program varies, and when used daily, a program for children with autism can incorporate anywhere between a few minutes to several hours per day of DTT. The question for the amount of DTT a person with autism should receive is debated in research. Regardless, when a person with autism begins DTT treatment, they should require less and less DTT over time. At this point, you may be starting to ask, what are the main components of discrete trial training? How do I go about implementation? First, the following should be noted. DTT is not a standalone treatment and should always be used in conjunction with other research-based treatments, such as incidental teaching, pivotal response training, and others. DTT should be individualized based upon learner's age, learning style, and overall skills. DTT should be closely monitored, and changes to programming should always occur through a database decision process. The five main components are listed as follows. Cue, also known as discriminative stimulus, for short that would be the SD. Prompt, response, consequence, intertrial interval. It should be noted that these are just the components and the order of the trial depends on the response of the learner. But each trial starts off with a cue and always ends with intertrial interval. So a brief description of cue is that it is a clear, brief instruction that evokes a specific response. An example would be include do this, what is this. After that cue is provided, a response occurs, which is either correct or incorrect answer. If the answer is correct, a consequence is provided, which is typically in the form of verbal praise, preferred tangibles, preferred activities. That's where the reinforcement is delivered. If an incorrect answer occurs, that is where the prompt comes in. The prompt occurs immediately after the cue or the SD. This is where time is taken to shape a correct response through modeling, through prompting, hand-over-hand prompting, typically least to most intrusive prompting. And then finally, the intertrial interval occurs. This is given after the consequence. And at this point, the therapist either will pause between 1 and 5 seconds, and they will provide the cue or the SD for the next trial. Bogin and Sullivan, 2010, provide step-by-step instructions for implementation of a discrete trial program for a learner with autism. Information for each step we provided here, and I recommend referring to the article for specific details. Step 1, deciding what to teach, assessment, and summarizing results. The article states that learning objectives need to be clearly defined, and you'll see an example up on the screen that has an antecedent behavior and criterion. We utilize this design ABC to have a refined objective that would read like this. When adult asks Michael to give two objects, that's the antecedent phrase, Michael will pick up two objects and hand them to the adult, the behavior phrase, in 80% of opportunities across 3 consecutive days, which is our criterion. Step 2, breaking the skill down into teachable steps, which includes steps or lesson progression. DTT is very significant with breaking skill downs into teachable steps. The article from Bogin Sullivan provides an example of how steps are broken down to teach identifying animals. Step 3, setting up the data collection system. In this step, it's very important, depending on the skill being taught, to pick the appropriate data sheet that will measure correctly and accurately the skill towards criterion. This table provided in the article has suggested materials to include in your data collection system. Step 4, designating locations or a location in which a teaching can take place. This step provides some considerations for an optimal learning environment within a discrete trial program. Step 5, gathering materials. Assemble materials to be used during the teaching. In this section, we see a list of materials needed in order to run an efficient discrete trial programs. All materials should be readily available and easy to use. Step 6, delivering the trials. As discussed early in this video, the steps are cue, prompt, response, consequence, and inter-trial interval. Step 7, masked trial teaching. This is where we repeat the same learning trial over and over several times in a row and to ensure the learner is successful multiple times in whatever the current step is at that time. The steps perform a mass trial beyond the current scope of this video and is recommended to read the appropriate section of the attached article for step-by-step details in this 11-step process. Step 8, conducting discrimination training. A big part of DTT is teaching learners to distinguish what they've learned when other distractors or stimuli is in place. The article provides 5 steps in teaching discrimination training. Step 9, review and modify. Of course, DTT and ABA is data driven, and these steps here include ways to utilize your data to most effectively have programs for your learner. Refer to the articles listed in this reference section for additional procedural details. Discrete trial training practitioners can include Board Certified Behavior Analysts, BCBAs, teachers, paraprofessionals, registered behavior technicians, also known as RBTs, and more. It can also include caregivers or parents that can be trained in implementation of DTT procedures. If you want to help disseminate the science, please subscribe and share with your friends, and thank you for watching.